Here's a recap of literally anything that happened during this 1 year of hiatus. Eleven days after the hiatus began, the Alt Press Music Awards took place in Cleveland, Ohio. This was on July 17th. 21 pilots were given an award for most dedicated fanbase, the click winning of a fellow nominees, Melanie Martinez, Paramore, and Paris. Josh Dunn turned up to pick up the trophy.
Oh, thank you.
This was the first and also the last time the band appeared in public at an award show. In a speech, Josh mentioned the word Dima for the very first time.
As a lot of you guys know, we're a two-piece band. Tyler wishes he could be here. He's actually off severing ties with Dima.
Back then, no one really knew what he meant by that. But 1 year later, it all starts to make sense. On July 26th, 21 pilots got nominated in the Best Rock category for Heavy Dirty Soul, respectively with Green Day, Fall Out Boy, Foo Fighters, and Coldplay. They even won the award for Best Rock Video.
It is 21 pilots. Ooh.
Next up, we got the Photoshop poster. You probably remember this and got really excited about it because there was a date on the poster, which obviously everyone thought was the date 21 pilots would return. But it was just too good to be true. July 27th. A fan spotted an ad for an upcoming new album on the subway. The click got very excited, as a subway poster appearing to reveal a return date for 21 Pilots. The ad went viral on Twitter after it was posted. The poster was designed in a style similar to a recent series of tweets sent from the band's official account announcing their hiatus, and appeared to suggest that some kind of release date from the band would be arriving on the 17th of November this year. A lot of fans, of course, got immediately hyped. Too bad it was fake.
Excuse me, could you please leave?
On the 2nd of August, musician and producer Josh Feldman posted a photo of him and Josh on his Instagram. Certain members of the clique immediately started analysing some suspected changes in Josh's hair colour, and whether it may hold any clues as to the band's future. Yep, this is how desperate we are for new music now. Basically, as you can see from this picture, Josh's sideburns look somewhat darker than the yellow shade he used to have. He's even began to come up with conspiracy theories about his new hair, and whether or not black-haired Josh might be a symbol associated with the new era. Keep in mind that this was back in August, and I don't even want to think how desperate those fans must be by now.
Oh, no.
On the 7th of August, New York Times made a series of US maps, showing where the biggest artists of 2017 are most beloved across the United States. The paper used geocoded data from YouTube to compile heat maps of the top 50 most watched artists in the United States between January 2016 and April 2017. And the results threw up some pretty interesting discoveries. Some of the biggest musicians were featured in this article, such as Justin Bieber, Beyonce, The Weeknd, Ariana Grande, Drake, Bruno Mars, and of course, 21 Pilots. This is what their map looked like. Tyler and Josh's occasional references to Christianity is thought to be partly responsible for their popularity in areas such as Utah, with a bigger religious sector. Meanwhile, here is the map for Panic at the Disco. Big spike over the Las Vegas area for Brendan. Can't imagine why. Josh Dunn is helping to fill the time while we wait for a new 21 Pilots album by popping up to collab with Lights. On August 10th, we found out that Josh played drums for the latest single from Lights called Savage. A few days later, a fan found a few interesting details, perhaps about what to expect from Tyler and Josh, or, more specifically, what the record might be called. The fan made an interesting discovery about the newly revamped 21 Pilots website. It turns out that when you hit search Google for image on the band's homepage logo, it reveals the message,
it says, don't do that again.
Don't do that again, including the space, just like the tweets from the band's previous Blurryface account. Then, when you search again, the word light appears. This reveals the message, 21 Pilots Echo, which is interesting given that Echo has long been thought of by fans as a potential title for the next album. On August 15th, former band member Chris Salee came on the 21 Pilots podcast, which is a podcast held by 21 Pilots fans on SoundCloud. Salee revealed what the original names of the group were back in their pre-fame days, and they were... interesting. The host of the 21 Pilots podcast, Christopher Robinson, had an in-depth interview with the group's original drummer, Chris Salee, who left the band amicably in 2011, just prior to the release of Regional at Best. And he revealed some of the other potential choices the boys were playing with in their early days in Columbus. Salee said, "We were on a couple of things. We were almost Bicycle Thief, which I think that there's already a band called Bicycle Thief, So that may be the first thing we didn't do. We were almost chillcoat. Actually, the attorney that I use for my business now is called Chillcoat Law. It's funny because Tyler knew of his name and thought it was cool, so we were kind of going back and forth on that. In fact, the boys got so desperate in their search for a name that they were looking through newspapers and even using code words you have to put on Ticketmaster for inspiration. Yes, really. Thankfully, they finally settled on the All My Sons reference from Arthur Miller, which we all know and love today. On August 17th, we saw some cryptic activity for the first time on the official band's website, even though it was more of a bit of a joke. 21 Pilots have always been up for a good laugh, from Tyler and Josh's Twitter jokes to their silly interviews and games on extreme phone pitching.
Holy crap,
Jeez,
Tyler.
Dude, what are you... Oh my god.
Oh no. Your phone. Oh, put your phone in there. Yeah. Careful. Careful. Josh, careful. Oh, it's so...
Oh no.
In the elevator? Dude. Josh, careful. Don't. The acceleration.
So it should all be no surprise that the official website also contains a joke for fans of the Aero 404 page. A fan spotted the joke on the band's official merch page and screenshotted it. So, what do the boys put on the site when things go wrong? A Celine Dion reference. Obviously. We all know how much Josh, but especially Tyler, likes to make jokes about Celine Dion. Tyler and Josh have long expressed their love for the singer, covering Titanic classic, My Heart Will Go On, during the emotional roadshow.
Collaborate with any musician, who would it be?
Oh man, that's just such an easy question.
I've been looking for Celine Dion.
I know that you guys like Celine Dion. We've heard you guys singing some covers of Celine Dion during your show. Could you guys maybe give us your best Celine cover of one of your songs, like Ride?
Tyler literally even bowing to her as she took the stage at the Germany Awards earlier this year. Halfway through September, we saw the first rumors about upcoming new music. Someone claimed that Atlantic Records were preparing a new single release before the end of the year. The post has also been doing rounds on Instagram, with many fans commenting that it was fake. However, some people on Reddit and Twitter have claimed to heard further rumors about publishing deals being written and masters being passed around the label. Even though we have been here before, the details of Heathens, the band's one-off single on the soundtrack of Suicide Squad, leaked online long before its release. The Click also shared details of the Heavy Dirty Soul video before it was officially announced. After all, this was unfortunately just a rumor, since we haven't heard any new music up until this day. On September 21st, 21 Pilots did something pretty remarkable. They got officially added in the Book of Guinness World Records for 2018. So what record did Tyler and Josh manage to break? Fastest Mario Kart track completion? It was for most streamed group and album of the year. Quite an achievement, in fact. They got added in this record list, along such artists as Drake, The Chainsmokers, Rihanna, Zayn, and Justin Bieber. On the 25th of September, Gerard Way reacted to the cover of Cancer by 21 Pilots in September of 2016. The former lead singer of My Chemical Romance praised 21 Pilots' cover of Cancer in an exclusive interview with PopBuzz. Tyler and Josh recorded their cover of the My Chemical Romance song, taken from the album The Black Parade, for a 10th anniversary compilation for Rock Sound. When Gerard got asked if he had heard their take on the song, he revealed just how delighted he had been with the new version. Way said, "Oh yeah, I did hear that one. It was great. I was really impressed. I didn't know what to expect and I was surprised by what I heard. Because there's a bit of rejuggling of parts and I was like, wow, this almost sounds like a remix. But it was a cover by way of this kind of rearrangement and I was really impressed with it. I like the band anyway. I like the sound of them. I think what they do is really interesting. So I was psyched to hear that cover." On the 27th of September, a video appeared on Twitter of Josh recording a special message for a fan with leukemia. We didn't really need any more proof that Josh Dunn was one of the nicest humans on Earth, but this video confirms it for anyone who might have been in doubt. A fan uploaded the video Josh recently made for their cousin, who has leukemia, which is a type of cancer. In his message, Josh wishes the girl a quick recovery, he said, by the time we get out there to play a show. Fans praised Josh for reaching out to the girl.
"Hi Angelina, this is Josh from 21 Pilots. I've heard that you're very sick, and I'm sorry to hear that. I hope that you're being strong and recovering right now, and hopefully by the time we get out there to play a show, you'll be all recovered, and we'll see you there.
Someone else who praised 21 Pilots was Justin Bieber. The singer posted a video of himself on his Instagram stories, saying how sick their performance of Heathens was.
So sick.
Bieber then followed that up with a second video saying, 21 Pilots are dope, and that was a dope performance.
21 Pilots are dope, and that was a dope performance. Good job, guys.
It's not the first time that Justin has showed his appreciation for the band. At a Q&A session, Justin was asked about his favorite song, and he replied, Stressed Out.
What is your favorite song?
My favorite song. Right now, my favorite song. I like that 21 Pilots song. I forget what it's called.
On October 15th, Josh ran another marathon in his hometown of Columbus. The marathon's official Twitter account posted a photo on October 15th of Josh modeling his finishing medal after completing the 13.1-mile course. Over 18,000 people took part in the event. According to WTHR, Josh completed the marathon in a very respectable time of 1 hour, 44 minutes, and 46 seconds. His brother, Jordan Dunn, captured it and posted it on Instagram. On the 25th of November, fans discovered a mysterious date on the band's Wikipedia page, when a recent update on the band's Wikipedia page appeared to list the record's title and release date. A lot of fans got very excited. The page listed the band's new album as Silence, with a drop date of February 11th, 2018. The post has since been deleted. Silence and Tower of Silence has been a rumored title for some time after the band posted the phrase on their social feeds and website to signify their current hiatus. Posts on Tumblr, Reddit, and Twitter spread these rumors even further, but unfortunately, it was all just the work of a fan. You have to keep in mind that anyone can add things to Wikipedia. On November 25th, we found out that Josh has a puppy. Just when fans were ready to complain on Twitter once again about how long the hiatus has been going on for, or the fact that the Emoji Movie exists, Josh's brother Jordan Dunn posted a picture of him and dog Jim. Jordan brought the news with a picture on Instagram. Josh made a private Instagram account for Jim to share pics. On January 16th, some fans thought they might have discovered some early details about the band's return later this year. A 21 Pilots-related account posted a message that appeared to confirm a September live show at the KFC Yum Center in Louisville. The tweet, of course, immediately went viral as fans analyzed it for clues about its legitimacy. It didn't take long for the click to find out the details were fake. The tweet got deleted just a few minutes after it got posted. A little while later, the account was deleted as well. However, timing-wise, this could make sense. 21 Pilots will most likely be back with new music at some point this year, and September would make sense for some early tour dates around the release date. Unfortunately, it was too good to be true. January 17th, the Chainsmokers uploaded their music video for Sick Boy on YouTube. A lot of angry fans complained about the new song over Twitter, and pretty much immediately the Chainsmokers dropped the new song. Many have been bombarding social media with angry comments for one specific reason. They think Sick Boy sounds like a 21 Pilots song.
This is us, this is, I live on the west side of America, where they spin lies into fairy dust.
Someone commented, I'm sorry, but do the Chainsmokers really just attempt to make Heathens 2.0? And make it one of their worst songs released to date? Oh my god, the vocals didn't even align with the beat. On January 25th, Fall Out Boy bassist Pete Wentz revealed how he was inspired by 21 Pilots. Pete talked about it in a column for a magazine, Variety. Pete Wentz praised artists like Lorde and Lil Yachty, The Beatles, Imagine Dragons, and 21 Pilots in his column. He said, "Today you can't necessarily think rock music has to be this and it can't be that. We're challenging the notion of what rock music can be. Listening to a playlist might mean going from a Beatles song into 21 Pilots into Lil Yachty." Pete goes on to praise 21 Pilots. The band has a very unique and interesting sound. This was one of the reasons Fall Out Boy invited the band to join them in tour in 2013. Pete said, "A rock song has to stand out. 21 Pilots did. That's why we took them on tour, and I saw how they tapped into something by taking different genres and incorporating rap. It's melodic. It's interesting. And it's clearly a recipe for success, because it can also get played on the radio. On January 29th, fans started to theorize online that there may well be a US tour towards the end of the year, but also that the band might play a lot of different summer festivals. At first, this idea kind of made sense, because a lot of fans expected the new album, or at least a new single, to drop off after 1 year of hiatus, which is during the summer period. With new music, many fans in the clique were wondering when Tyler and Josh might make a return to the stage. Even though these are just a few random theories, they're kind of interesting. If they're going to pop up on an outdoor stage in 2018, here's the festivals the clique expect them on. Number 1. Reading and Leeds Festival. This would be the obvious choice. The band tore up the stage during their appearance in 2016 with the crowd hysteria, proving that they had already outgrown the Radio 1 tent and were ready for the main stage. By now, the lineup for the festival has already been announced, and as we know, 21 Pilots isn't a part of it. Number 2. Bestofol. This festival is known for its unique headliner choices. According to the theory, this could be the place where 21 Pilots finally make their debut. Plus, they have a circus scene this year. The perfect fit for Tyler's acrobatic stage presence. Number 3. KROQ. The radio station always gets the biggest alternative acts of the year for its annual festival shows, so this would actually make sense if they would play any festivals this summer, which is most likely not going to happen. 21 Pilots would be a safe bet for this festival, depending on the record's final drop date. December or early 2019 looks more likely. On February 6th, All Time Low's Jack Barakat posted a photo on his Twitter. On this photo we saw Alex, Jack, Brendan, and Josh, and the heads of Fueled by Ramen. This was one of the first times we got a proper photo of Josh with his new natural hair. On 11th of February, producer and musician John Feldman posted a photo on his Instagram. On this photo we saw John himself, Josh, Mark Hoppus, and the members of the band called The Fame. They've been working on their debut album in Los Angeles with producer John Feldman, who has previously worked with everyone from Panic at the Disco to Andy Black. Plus, Blink-182's Mark Hoppus and 21 Pilots' Josh Dunn have also been seen hanging out in the studio for writing lessons. On February 26th, 21 Pilots got nominated at the Kids' Choice Awards. They got nominated in the music categories for Favorite Music Group. Last year, they won the Kids' Choice Award for Favorite New Artist. They competed against Fifth Harmony and the Chainsmokers for the award. Fifth Harmony ended up winning the award on March 24th. On March 12th, a very unexpected video popped up on Drake Bell's Instagram story, with new footage showing him in the studio with former Nickelodeon star Drake Bell. Drake posted clips on his Instagram story that showed Josh playing along with a vocal track that could well be new music from Drake Bell. Fans were pretty excited to see Josh back at work, plus there was the added excitement of this collab putting a whole new twist on the pairing, Drake and Josh. So what did this mean? Was Josh doing some session work for Drake's new album? Was Drake just hanging out while Josh worked on some 21 Pilots demos? Drake Bell's last musical release was his EP, Honest, back in 2017. Around the 10th of April, this Friday the 13th theory exploded all over Twitter, Reddit, YouTube, and Instagram. The theory said 21 Pilots would end their hiatus after 280 days, 40 weeks. This is because of the supposed religious significance of the number 40 in Christianity and Tyler and Josh's faith. Eventually, the theory was wrong, because they didn't come back from their hiatus, even though the theory actually kind of made sense. After all, the whole theory was probably a bit extra. Just because Tyler is a Christian, that doesn't mean he would devise an entire album release strategy around the significance of the number 40. Despite this, fans were tweeting the theory and getting very excited about the possibility of new 21 Pilots music. Once again, too good to be true. On April 22nd, we first heard about the dmaorg.info website. Fans discovered that the 21 Pilots merch store linked to a website. However, fans then discovered another website under an error code /Clancy. After the site went down, it came back with some minor changes and some images and clues, including a diary by someone called Clancy. Now, 2 months later, it's slowly making sense, even though they'll probably drag this Clancy theory out as long as possible to keep the fans busy. Recently, they updated the DMA org website again, with a GIF of a cheetah with some letters on top of the GIF. And that's it. That is about everything that's happened in this 1 year of hiatus. Undoubtedly, a lot more cryptic stuff and theories will follow in the next few months. Let's just hope they're coming back very soon.
We're 21 Pilots and so are you. We'll see you next time. Peace.
Hey everyone, I am Gingersheep. I am the person who did the commentary for this video for Pillow Pilots. I also make primarily 21 Parts related content as well, and I would very much appreciate it if you checked out my channel. Thank you.
Since no one actually knows when the 21 Parts hiatus will eventually end, maybe Siri, the automated assistant, will know. Siri, am I going to die before 21 Pilots come back?